Hey guys, welcome back. Every time you record a macro, your actions are translated into the programming language VBA. As I said to previous lectures, the easiest way to open Visual Basic Editor is to press Alt F11. VBE contains several windows and is highly customizable. On your left, you can see a project panel and a project window. If you can't see that, for example, let's delete it. Go to menu bar and click View tab, which contains commands that you use to do things with the various components in VBE, and click Project Explorer. Below we have the Properties window. It's not so useful and you will use it most of the time to change the name of the macro. To the right there is a window called Code window. Every object in a project has an associated code window which contains VBA code. If it's not present, go again to View and select Code. If it's blank, open the plus icon of the modules and double-click one of these. You can customize the size of all the editor parts by moving this vertical split line. Code windows are much like workbook windows in Excel. You can minimize, maximize, resize, hide, rearrange them and more. I like to maximize the code window so that I can see more code and reduce distractions. This course is not about being proficient, but we'll learn a lot of basic principles. If you want to change the name of the macro, simply go there and change it to Bold Macro. We also explained in previous lecture that placing a single apostrophe in front of any text creates a comment and turns the text green. Let's delete these lines. If you deleted a statement that you shouldn't have, use the Undo button on the toolbar or press Ctrl-Z until the statement appears again. Over time, you will begin to understand many of these code lines. If a single line of VBA code is long enough, then you can use the line continuation character to break up lengthy lines of code. To continue a single line of code, also known as a statement, from one line to the next, end the first line with a space followed by an underscore, then continue the statement on the next line. On the left side in the Visual Basic window, you see modules. The workbook that we've currently opened has two modules. I'm gonna click Module 2. You see a different macro there. You can easily change the name of module by simply going to Properties window. You see the name down below. Click in this text box and rename it. Great! One last thing that I want to say is that you can cut the code from a module and paste it into another or a new one. We can have multiple macros into a single module. I will do an example with module 1 and a new module. Double-click on it, and as you can see, it has two different macros. This one and this one. Highlight the code that sets the font to bold carefully, press Cut. Now, right-click to Modules folder, create a new module and paste the code. Now, the new module with the code inside is ready. So, you take your first look behind the curtain to explore Visual Basic Editor. Let's continue to the next lecture.